Hello, Wyandottes.
Where are my favorite chicks that I just released? Where are they? They're like their mama. You see their mamas? Those are the laced Cochins. That's what I call them. They're laced. See how they look like lace? One brown lace one. There it is right there. And two black ones. Aren't they pretty? They're real friendly towards me. Because I've been babying them. But here they are. Uh-oh. Here they come. Let's get to it.
Hello, this is Jamerica with Jamerica Life. So it's been raining. It's been raining here. And I haven't been harvesting. And you know what they say about okra, right? Okra waits for no woman. Okra's been growing. So I have the water on. I'm gonna turn it off for a minute so I can get this okra out because I'm running out of time. It will get woody on me super quick. So I have to water, but I have to get the okra. So I have to make a choice, right? Early in the morning, I got time. Turn the water off. Say hi to our mama spider. Right there. She was right down here, but she got tired of me coming up here, so she moved. She moved away from me. She left me. She only went about a foot, but she's out of my way now. I guess she said, before I have to bite this woman, I'm gonna go ahead and move the web. So we're going out here to the okra and see what we have. We have some stuff that has developed, some okra that has developed and gotten quite big. So hopefully we don't have any woody ones. If we do, I'll just pull them off. Do not leave them on there. It'll stop your production, okay? So let's get to it, all right? Woo!
Hands are working. Make sure they don't bite me. Let's see. Here you gotta look, because it hides. Gotta look at different angles, because they hide from you. On purpose, playing hide and go seek with the okra. What's dragging this thing down? Cucumber. Look at the cucumber vine. See this? See how this okra is hanging over? It's because of this. Cucumber vine. Cucumber vine is doing it in, dragging it down to the ground. And cucumbers are heavy. So we need to unhinge this. Unhand my okra.
Look at that cucumber hanging. Poor okra is fighting for its life. Pull that off. We gotta get this one down. It's dragging my okra down. And the cucumber will be gone long before the okra will. So let's fix this. Look at what I got. Looky, looky. Can't step in there. Okay, I got it down as much as I could. Let's go ahead and move. Look around, look around. Okay. This is what I got, too, from that. Not step on anything. There's stuff growing out here. It rained, so I got new flowers. I'll show you in a sec. I think this watermelon is probably done. Let me see. No, it's not. It's not. It's still yellow. There's one here that turned brown, but the flower has fell off from there. This one belongs to this one, so I'll just leave it here. And let me see here. There's a squash here that has turned yellow. see if it's ready. Yeah, it's small. I'll leave it there. Just look down here. These are also cucumbers and melons. See that? Let's go over here. Melon decided it wanted to grow in the dirt. And what is this? This is a cucumber. Pull this one out. Get that one off. Put it in a bucket. Yay. So here's what we have so far. Okay. Get the bucket and let's go. It's really peaceful out here. It's really peaceful out here in the morning. Let me fix this hat. Because it's look at that sky. Does that look real? I love the Texas sky. I don't remember how it looked in New York, but I don't think it looked like that. It looked like whipped cream, doesn't it? Looks like whipped cream. Enough nostalgia, or I don't remember. Something ate my cucumber. This is why you need to harvest, because these animals, they will eat your stuff. They have no conscience, none. I ain't gonna leave it there for them. I give it to chickens. I ain't leaving nothing. I need a BB gun, I tell you that. Well, I have a BB gun. We're gonna put it together. Let's see here. All right, we gotta go across these melon and squash and get to the rest of the stuff. Ah, my melon split. Darn it. You know what that's from? Inconsistent watering. My fault. Shoot. And if something eat something, let me show you this, because it split and then I think something went in there and ate it. Or tried to eat it. Chickens are getting that. This one is ready. This squash is ready, but I'm gonna get this melon out first. No, something broke this thing open. Something bit it, and then it popped. Look at this. Yeah, look at that. I think it's got teeth mark in it. And they were, look at that. They ate as much as they could. Let's go ahead and give this to the chickens, because I'm getting upset. These rabbits, and it's possible rats. We got roof rats around here. Oh, we used to. They don't go away like that. I used to poison them constantly. And then there's bug damage. But the bugs did not get through. The bugs didn't get through. Something ate it and popped it. Let's go and give it to the chickens. I'm gonna put my fence up so my dogs, well, the dogs will tear up the garden though. So I can't win for losing. You ever heard that expression? Man, I get something out of it. I give it to the chickens, huh? Save me on some feed. They love watermelon. Apparently other things do too. They realize that there's a goodness, gooey goodness inside, and they need to come and harvest it before I get to it. Makes me want to pull that other one up. You know, watermelon wars versus me getting the watermelon. I'm gonna always pick me. I don't care about I care about it, but I don't really care. My win is getting a watermelon that I can eat without this happening. Out my hand. Gratitude. I tell you what, stop. It's not for you. Do not do that again. It's taking them out of my hand. Girl, I'm not picking them up for you. If one, next time somebody do that, I'm going to bop you upside your head. Freaking birds. I'm trying to get harvest some of the seeds, right? And they taking them out of my hands. Let's go back into the harvest. Look, I got my seeds. Back to the garden, back to the harvest. Let's see, we'll go around this way this time. I'm not gonna get any strawberries. I'm pretty sure I'm not going to, but I'll have some strawberries for next year. So I'm happy about that. And my Adler plum showed back up, thank goodness. Putting it in this bucket so that it could constantly get water was the best thing I could have done. I isolated it because I didn't know if it was a disease or not. Apparently it was just water. Wasn't getting enough water. So let's go around here. Around the fig tree. I've been getting figs little by little every day. There it is. I'm using my hand. Every day I get a little bit. Just a little bit. There's another one right there. And this one is also producing. Every day I get a little bit. And I think I'm gonna get some more because they keep on budding. You gotta look on these things because if you don't, they'll fall to the ground and something else will eat it for you. This one hasn't given me anything yet, but I'm hopeful. This is the biggest one. Sometimes the biggest one is not the, you know, the best. But we'll see, you know, everything in due time. I'm not gonna curse it yet. It's still a good fig tree. It's a nice fig tree. Look at those. Mm-hmm. So here's the other one that I wanted to harvest. It's a squash. Let me look and see if it's ready. No, it's not ready. It's not ready. Not ready. Not ready. Okay. You know what I'm starting to like more than anything? Kushaw. 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 Still haven't gotten anything from these delicatas. As far as I know. But we'll see today, huh? Maybe there's something showing up that we didn't see. Maybe it's hiding out from me. So let me tiptoe through this stuff. These sweet potatoes over here. These sweet potatoes out of control. All right, got over here. All right, so gotta remember, these are motherland okra, okay? So they're gonna look different, but that one's way too small. I'm not gonna take that one yet, but it grows, motherland okra. And I heard that people were having trouble with that, but it came up for me. Here's one that's ready. And I believe I just threw these seeds down. I didn't transplant these. I'm sure I didn't transplant these. Sure. I was like, shoot, I'd be doggone if I be out there fighting with these okra. Here's another one right here. Okay. Where's my bucket? All the way on the other side. Let me put them right down here till I'm done. Hopefully I don't step on it. Put some down on it. Spend a little time on it. There's another one right there. That's a little one, but I'm gonna take it anyway. I think I'm gonna make something with it. Ants are doing what they do. There they are. There they are right there. Pollinated. Pollinating. Free of charge. Well, they're getting the pollen, right? So they're charging me. I don't want the pollen, so it don't matter to me. They could have had a pollen. Just don't bite me. Let's see. Oh, there's one right over there. Be careful, Jamerica. Don't step on nothing. put this tarp down so that I have somewhere to walk, but the plants decided that it wanted to use a tarp. Here's another one right down here. Pull that off. Okay. Woo! All right. It don't look like a lot until I go and put it back in the basket. I'm gonna see how much I got from just being out here. I don't know, less than an hour. Yeah. So this used to be open where I could walk down here, but the sweet potatoes decided otherwise. So I'm gonna have to tiptoe through this thing. There was a hole here. Let's go around. Turn ourselves around. Get that okra right in here. Get that. See that one? Get that one. And there's one right in here. Oh, there's another one. And that's a big one. I gotta get that because you do not want these jokers to start going to seed. It slows down production. See that? That's getting too big. But it's not woody yet, so. That's a plus. Let's look at this one over here. Make sure that we don't forget nothing because I won't have to go through this again. Now let's try to do an about face and get up out of here. All right. Pivot. So let's get these up. Here we go. Get up out of here. Oh, I forgot to give these to the chickens, but I'll be heading back in a second. All right, so we've already looked at that. We got to go around because I see some okra on the other side. And while we're here, we're going to look at these plants. Inspect them. Make sure there's nothing going on with them that you don't know about. Just take a look, a gander. A good gander. While you're walking by, always look at your stuff because you never know. You never know what you're going to find. Might be fruit. It might be something else. So, always look. Always look. All right. So, I saw some more okra on this side. Or one or two over here that I need to get off. Yep, they're huge too. They need to go. Let's put this up here. Here's one here. Now somebody told me that you're supposed to break these things off, but they are not the easiest to come off. So I'm gonna leave them alone. Here's another okra. Just pop it off. Another one. And another one. Let's take them off. All right, let's take a look, a brief look around to see if there's anything else in here hiding. Like this one. It's not just okra I'm looking for. I'm looking for anything that is ready to be harvested. I know that my beans have gone kaput. I need to replant. Beans don't last very long. They give you what they got. They give you everything they got. And then they just start looking like that. It's a good thing I like okra. That's why I planted it. My basil. It's trying to go to seed, but I keep on pinching it back. Let's look at the zucchini. There's one down here that I needed, something ate it. Ain't that a blip? Look at that. Yo, there's another one though. So let's get this bad one out here. This one. Take it off. Take it off. I'm not gonna give it to the chickens. But while I'm down here, look at this. This one is hiding. See that? Get that off. They'll take it for you. So, one is for recycle and one is going in my basket. Take this. We do not give anything fermented to the chickens. They'll get sick on you. Sauerkraut. Throw it in the trash. If it's rotten, if you can't eat it, most likely your chickens can't eat it. You know, you give them, I mean, I know there's some people give their chickens table scraps, but table scraps mean that it's still good. Look at my poor moringa. I gotta come in here and give it some give it some water. But if it's rotten food, don't give it to your chickens. If you have pigs, go ahead and give it to them. They got stomachs. Chickens, they have those little gullets. I don't know, it's crops. They're crops. That's where they store their food. And that thing will swell up on them and they'll be gone. They'll be gone with 24 hours. They swell up and you'll see them throwing up. That's what I call it. You see them throwing up and that'll be the end of them. Let's look in here some more. Here's another flower coming up. That's good. I think I only planted two or three of these, but every day I come out here, every other day I come out here and there's a big old one waiting for me. Yeah, I think I planted three, and all three of these on this side survived. I think it's because of this basil. The basil is giving off such a strong scent that they can't smell this joker. At least they haven't yet. Thank goodness. Because I didn't know if I was gonna get anything because they got me on the other side. Let me look through here. I don't see anything. That doesn't mean there ain't nothing in there though. So, all right, sweet potatoes. I promised y'all I was gonna go and get these sweet potatoes because they are on. Do I see some growing in there? No, that's a sweet potato slip. Because they are growing on this tarp, but I just don't have it in me today to do it. What we're gonna do is we're gonna go through. See these vines growing up on top of this tarp? I'm just gonna harvest the whole vine. The whole vine, because I want the leaves. I might high harvest the leaves because I could keep on coming back and harvesting sweet potato leaves. They taste good. They taste like spinach, except better. So I have a whole bunch of them. Might as well use them for something, right? All right, let's go on to the other side. You got to get what you can get while the getting is good. Look at this. Look at that. That's beautiful. Still got a flower on it. All right. Put it on my hip. So I have a whole bunch of eggplants showing up, but they're not big enough. They're not ready. I'll show you them. They're pretty. Look at that. That's an eggplant. Right there is another eggplant where my hand is. Look at this eggplant. They look like Christmas, you know, balls that you put on the tree. Look at that. I'm gonna plant this again next year. I didn't have any luck with it until I started planting them around this garden. Last time I planted it on the other side is not as treacherous though. That's the wild wild west over there. We got some tomatoes out there. Let me go and get them. Go and get them. Get them, girl.
Put your britches up. Oh Lord. Let's get these first. What are you doing?
Look at that. Look at that. He gone. I got a cat call for my chickens.
they started ignoring me though because I've given them a couple of false alarms. That's all right. They'll be fine. They're gonna miss out if they keep on ignoring me. Okay, it's a little handful. Handful of sugar makes the medicine go down. The medicine go down. Medicine go down. It's just a spoonful of sugar makes the medicine go down. It's the most delightful.
I was gonna turn you off, but we can still walk. I could walk with the camera. Let me see. I see a cucumber. Is that a cucumber looking at me? It sure is. Right there. I think. Let me make sure it's not a honeydew because I think I put honeydew out here. I could tell by smelling the leaves if it's cucumber or not. The vegetable sniffer.
That is not a cucumber. That's a honeydew. Nope, not gonna touch it.
That's a honeydew. Cucumbers have a scent. No scent, which means it's a honeydew, because honeydews and most watermelons, I have to sniff them at the watermelon. I mean, sniff them at the watermelon, sniff them at the grocery store. Look how dirty I got. All right. I'm getting tired. You ever get tired of harvesting? That's a good thing, right? Look at that. This basket is about 15 pounds. Yeah. So let's go and look for some more stuff in here. I'm just gonna go through a little bit and then I'm gonna see if there's anything in there. I don't know, there might be some cucumbers. I know I planted cucumbers in there, so let's look. Nothing. All right. Let's go and get these little tomatoes that are left in the raggedy old garden. A little bit. Keep looking, girl. Keep on looking. I see Kushaw in here. That's about it, and it's not ready. Brussels sprouts are still trying to make it. All right. All right, here's what I got from this garden. It's probably more, but I don't have my stick with me, so we'll go on to the other side. Come back out here when I have a cane so I can make sure I can pop Jake on his head permanently.
This joker's still producing peaches. It's up there. I don't know if you can see it. I'm trying to get as close as possible. It's right there. And they getting big. Too bad I don't like the peaches on this joker. And it's just for show right now.
For privacy. Privacy is important to me.
All right. Let's get this up.
And let's get to going. See a tomato in there. See, I don't have the energy. Uh-oh, that's a pepper. I'm going to get that. Oh, no, I'm going to get that. A red pepper back there that I don't have. And look. Look at what they did. I hope it was a hot pepper. I hope it was a hot pepper and they got what they deserved. Thieving things. They ate a little bit of it. Probably was hot. It's happened before. They eat a little bit and they be like, oh my God, why is my mouth burning? I'm in pain. Just desserts. Okay, let's get this up without dropping anything. I don't think I have any bell peppers ready. I do have one that's not doing well, so I'm gonna get it off of there. If you see anything that's rotting or doesn't look well on your plants, go ahead and take them off. Take it off. This one, something trying to eat it. No, I guess it might be the rose bushes attacking it. I'm gonna take it off anyway. And birds be complaining. My birds be, they complain. Not even normal cockadoodle. Well, I ain't gonna say that because I don't want no more of that. I gotta go back out there and check on them today. They could cockadoodle do all they want out there. All right. Let's go. Hope my basket don't break because this thing is heavy. It's a Dollar Tree basket. I bet this basket was made for this kind of. Come on. You hear her? Lord have mercy. I got some peppers over here that I need to get off. Here's my basket. Let's get these habaneros off. These things put out. Once I grow these things, I refuse to let them go because peppers take about 14 days to come up. That's why when I got these, because I only got a few Scotch bonnet seeds. When I got these four growing, when I saw them getting ready to kaput on me, let me fix this camera. When I saw them get ready to leave me, I up-potted them and put them somewhere I could see them because that don't make no sense. You go through all of that stuff trying to get stuff to germinate and it takes 14 days for peppers. Peppers are not quick. And then they pass away on you. Okay, let me wash this off and I'll be right back. I got 10 seeds. Yay. They ate all the rest of them. I just looked in there. There ain't nothing but a puddle of watermelon water. All right, put these right here. Here we go. Cucumber with the baby ants on it. Bell pepper. Let me bring you closer. You too far. Zucchini. It was turning yellow on me. I didn't know it was there. More cucumbers. Is that a cucumber? Yeah, that's a cucumber. Cucumber. I could have swore there was another squash. Wait a minute. Okay. All right, there's another cucumber. There's all the cucumbers. Oh, that squash was no good. That's why it ain't here. And we got our okra. Let me see if this one's woody. Yep. If you touch the tip, take your nail, put it on the tip, and look at that. Woody ones do this. You see that? They become fibrous, and I don't eat them, so. The seeds are not dried out. Most of the time, if you try to dry these out, they mold, so. And I'm just gonna throw it back in the yard. Here's another one that looks suspect. Take your nail. Is it? Man, this one's a nut. This one's borderline. I'm gonna keep this one. Borderline. Here goes another cucumber. Here goes one they robbed me of. So I'm break it up and I'm gonna throw it in the chicken coop. More okra. More okra, yay. If you don't like okra, don't cook, don't plant it. But I like okra. I love okra, actually. Yes, there's two sides. There's two people. People who like okra, love okra, and people who love and like okra, and people who hate it. I can eat it raw. Here goes some tomatoes. Scotch bonnet. Habanero. Habanero. I'm going to put all the peppers together, right, so you can see it. Tomatoes are coming to a standstill because it's getting hot. Flowers are falling off. As long as I keep them alive, I'll get some more at the end of August through December. Okay. There we are. Well, every day a little bit. You know it adds up, right? Some people think that you got to get a big harvest. And sometimes I do. If I had harvested the sweet potatoes, this table would be full or half full. Because there's a lot of them out there. There's a lot of leaves out there. But I'll do that on another video because it's going to be timely. That's going to be timely. This is enough for 3 or 4 days. Yep. I'm just going to add it to the rest of the stuff. This right here, I'm giving this to the chickens. Oh, it smells good too. They got me for a good one, huh? Look what they did to the watermelon. I'll show you. Ain't nothing but a puddle left. Yeah. Ain't nothing but a puddle. Here you go. Let me see if I can get another seed out of here. I guess they said, we don't want no more right now. Let me get this out of the sun and put it in the shade. It's going to get hot here, and I don't want this thing going to waste any more than it's already been, you know, not waste. They do not like hot stuff, and it's going to get hot. It just ain't hot right now because it's early. Somebody in there agonizing. Let me see what's going on in here. I open this door a little bit more anyway. Let me make sure I don't drop my 3 seeds. This is why they're complaining. Look at this. I would say a bad word, but y'all ain't gonna like it. And then there's another one over here. The one making noises right there. Move my finger. My camera just fell off the stand. So. Bringle, they tired of you, girl. Let me open this up. She stay in this box. Broody. And they like, I'm sick of you. You need to give up the box, girl. I told you those little ones that are Dum Dum's kids are mean.
Had to back this one up because I couldn't believe that this chicken was playing football defense with me.
I told you those little ones that are Dum Dum's kids are mean. She went up under her. Let me see if there's an egg in here. I don't want them to break the egg. Look, meanie. Is there an egg in here? I don't care if y'all fight. Just don't break my eggs. And don't you peck me. Y'all gonna fight it out. I ain't gonna do nothing. You two. Look, Rhode Island Red. I know you want a box. There's not one available right now. Stop making noise, please. I need to get this thing out of here, too. I got my little 3 seeds. Oh, now I drop one. I don't have 2 seeds left. Y'all made me lose my seed. Move. All right. Dry it out. Put it in the sun. Let it dry out. All that stuff fall off.
The rest I knock off with a stick. Oh, they got the cucumber. See, I told you my chickens don't waste nothing. They be like, what? What? She put a cucumber on here? Oh, I'ma get that girl. That's different. That's different than what we were eating earlier. Excuse me, sir. You were the last Mohegan. And you are gonna be with the rest of the roosters if you don't shut up. Do you understand? Don't make me talk to you again. I'm going out there today and you'll be in a box with them in the wilderness. See that? They eating the cucumber. Little Wanda's trying to eat me, big ones. Who's complaining? You? Girl, just go and find a corner somewhere. I only have two Rhode Island Reds. I didn't like them initially, but they're nice. Although they're complaining right now. I call them raptors. They don't have a name. The raptors. I should have called the other ones the raptors because they're mean. The Rhode Island Reds are not. Neither one of them. There's two of them. These hybrids. Where are the hybrids that are Dum Dum's kids? I'll show you what they look like. There's Dum Dum, right? That's Dum Dum, that brown one. And her daughters look like that. Like this one. And they are mean as Methuselah, that one. That's one of her daughters. You know how I know? Got an afro, just like Dum Dum. Dum Dum's a meanie, meanie, meanie. She's small though, mean but mighty. And here's her daughter, bigger and meaner. Because she's half Bard Rock, half Dum Dum. I don't know what Dum Dum is, so that's why I just called her Dum Dum because I thought she was dumb because she used to wait outside of the coop till the other birds got all settled and then she'd go in. Man, this bird is smarter than the rest of them. The rest of them was dumb. They was in there fighting, pecking each other. She waited till that all simmered down and then she would go in. But her daughters, that's not her daughter right there. This one is her daughter. For sure, for sure, for sure. See that afro? See the little afros on them? Anyway, I'm gonna stop complaining. Let's leave. Oh, the Wyandottes are getting something to eat. Yay. Wyandottes are fitting in. Wyandottes, they're good flyers, by the way. So be careful with them. They're beautiful, but they can fly. They fly farther than everybody else. Well, I'm back. So, I just want to talk to you guys a little bit before we leave. Never be afraid to plant stuff. Nobody has a black thumb. And gardening is not complicated. All you have to do is try. The more you do it, the better you get at it. And it's not hard. I mean, it's laborious. You see me sweating and you get me dirty. If you're afraid to get dirty, well, I don't know what to tell you. I'm dealing with dirt. So people think that you have to have a bucket. I'm not selling this at a store. I'm doing this for me and for this household. First of all, every day you got to go out there and every day you're going to get about a bucket full depending on what you grow. Unless you're using a bunch of fertilizers and chemicals and stuff that I don't use. You see that the animals and the bugs are on my stuff. Actually, I don't want to eat it if a bug ain't eating it. Because if a bug is not eating your plant, something's wrong with it. If there's no bug damage, why? Why wouldn't a bug, even a bug wouldn't touch that? That's a problem.
Now, Jamerica, it's like you put, we don't need to name names now, do we? No, we don't.
And 20 years later, you show up and that hamburger look exactly the same. Or a lot of these places be, they put all kind of preservatives in there and those things. Like these. When I go to the supermarket and buy a cucumber, it's got a wax coating on it. There's no wax coating on this. None. It feels different. It feels crisp. That's because it's not sprayed with wax or whatever chemical they're putting on those things. I have touched cucumbers at the supermarket and it felt like it was going to slip out of my hand. I don't know what they put on it. And then you got to take it home. You put some hydrogen peroxide in the water, more chemical to try to get that stuff off. You just try to grow it. Cucumbers especially are easy. A lot of these things are. Some of these things, you just put them in the ground. Cucumbers, drop the seed in the ground, cover it up, water it, and it'll come up. Okra is especially easy to grow. You put those seeds in the ground, And if you put too many, you're going to have to thin it out because most of them are going to come up. Okra is good. It's good for you. A lot of this stuff is good for you. Unless, you, of course, you go to the grocery store. And what I don't understand is that there are some vegans, so they say, who buy stuff from the supermarket and buy all this pre-made stuff. You're not truly, in my opinion, it's not truly vegan if it's nothing but chemicals like the ones that they try to make burgers out of. What are they putting in there? There's some things in, there's just some ingredients in some of those that I can't pronounce the word. I don't know what it is, which if you can't pronounce it, it's usually a chemical. If you can't pronounce it, it's usually a chemical. Dioxide and all this stuff, like it's a medicine or something. If you go back about, I started planting seeds in January because everything in that garden, with the exception of that pecan tree or any of the trees, with the exception, well, the, I shouldn't say any of the trees, the moringa I grew from seed, with the exception of a few trees, all of the plants in the garden, everything except that pecan tree in that garden over there, was planted by me, by seed, either in the house or directly in the ground. And all I did was put the seed in a little tray. I didn't even buy the tray. I got the tray for free. Put it in one of them little seed trays that hold the seed pods, and watered it. And then when it sprouted, I put it under light. I highly discourage anyone from listening to someone who is going to make you think it's hard, that you have to have a master's or a PhD in gardening in order to put something in the ground. It's not like that. Now, there is something that I want to talk about. So there are some of you, I remember when I was a little girl, we were living in Brooklyn, and there was a lady who asked the landlord, because we were in an apartment. My mom and I were in the bottom floor. And I remember my mom opening the window saying, "Girl, don't plant back there. There's nothing but lead back there," because it was nothing but buildings that they had knocked down and rubble. And the lady had cleared the land. She said, "Well, he said that we could use it." And they were trying to tell her there's lead in the soil, which is true. Because a lot of the buildings, like the paint, not this one, because this one is newer. But back in the day, before 1975, there's a disclaimer on a lot of houses that you buy saying that you won't sue them for asbestos and lead-based paint. They put an amendment into your contract about lead-based paint and how to be aware of it. Because if you ingest those, what is she jumping up there for? If you ingest those, there's always something going on. If you ingest those, it could drive you crazy. And gives you mental health problems and more problems. Lead is bad for you. Now, there's some other herbs that you could use to get it out of your system, but you don't want to get them in there because it's going to make you sick. So I know that this land was farmland. I know the people who used to own this land. So I'm not worried about that. If you don't know what was on your land and you're concerned, if you live in an inner city especially, go ahead and get your soil tested. Go ahead and do it for lead and heavy metals, because you don't want you and your kids to eat that stuff. That's one reason why you would have a raised bed. And when you have the raised bed, you need to put a liner to separate, a delineating line, like a tarp or something, to stop any of that ground stuff from coming up into your soil, because it'll travel up. If you just put a raised bed on top of the ground that is full of lead, that lead is going to come, it's going to mix in after a while. Put something under it, and it doesn't have to be plastic. Put something under it that is going to ensure that lead doesn't come back up. Some people think that you just put a raised bed on top of regular ground and that it's good to go when they have lead problem. Mm-mm. You need a barrier. So I'm in ground. Cause I'm on farmland, so I'm good. I'm good, good. I don't have to worry about me running around with the tinfoil hat on because I got lead poisoning. And if you do have lead in the soil, there's a way to eradicate it. Just there are some things that just pull that stuff up out of the ground. I think sunflowers is one of them. Just look it up. There's some plants that pull it up, but you got to keep on planting it and keep on testing until it said they say it's good. But inner city, yeah. Inner city, test that soil. Test it. My grandma told me that when I was a little girl. I lived in New York City. I was raised in New York City. So when I was growing, she was like, we got to get the soil tested. And I didn't understand why. But our house was built, I think, in 1942. That's how old our house is. And she knew, well, that when she bought that house, she was a second owner. So, but who's to say that there wasn't lead-based paint in our house? I don't think so, because I think she tested for it. And after a while, it's just you paint over it so much that it's gone. I don't remember ever having any... I think my uncle was the one who maintained the house, and he used water-based paint. I remember him saying, no, we ain't gonna use that. Where was he from? South Carolina? No, we ain't gonna use that. He was in one of my in-laws, my in-law uncle from, my aunt married this guy from South Carolina. So, anyway, I've talked enough. This is Jamerica with Jamerica Life. I thank you guys for being with me, and this is my harvest. From the garden. Yay. Hi, y'all. Bonus track. Guess where we're going? There was one thing I forgot, because it's high up. You know, if it's not in my line of vision and I'm really short, I'm not gonna remember. And it's that right there.
Two little pears hanging up on here.
Here we are. My pears. Got them.